everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. I had so much fun doing these little sticks and stones. I thought we would show you some more sticks and stones. Before I packaged them up, I wanted to share what they actually turned out looking like. And each one's different. Each one I knew who I was creating it for, so I tried to get something in there either by the number of people in the family or some of the vegetations, and I don't know, it just turned out to be a lot of fun. As I was trying to remember or think about how am I going to package these so that I can give them to people with all of the stones not falling off the sticks, I thought, I remember when Rick was making art boxes out of paper. And I thought, that would be even better because he's doing all of these beautiful prints from his quilt that he's been putting together for years and years. And the patterns are just becoming more and more beautiful. And I thought, wow, if I had boxes made out of Rick's art prints and art boxes, it would be a gift in itself just to get one of these boxes. That's when he said, yeah, I can do that. And I gave him the measurements. I wanted them to be 8 inches long because my longest one was going to be 8 inches. And then I wanted it to be 3 inches wide, but I wasn't quite sure how tall they'd have to be. So I thought maybe 3.5 inches would give me plenty of space. And that's when he went down to his computer. And this is the sort of thing he came up with. I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. I told him I was really having trouble cutting them out because I kept looking at the design instead of paying attention to where I should be cutting. Once we got them cut out, then it's a matter of folding it on the dark lines, gluing these tabs inside like you would see a cardboard box that you got from Amazon or wherever, and then inserting a little structure inside to give it some stability, because remember, these are just made out of photo paper. This is what it ends up looking like as it's finished. It's absolutely gorgeous.
The only thing we need to find now is a little Velcro tab, just to keep the little tab down.
Right. So I'm thinking maybe something inside. And then I was wondering what would be the best thing to put around it, and I thought of Excelsior or shredded paper, even tissue paper, but for some of these fine pieces, that would just be too harsh. So instead, tissue right out of the box is going to be my go-to packing. And I'll pack the whole thing with tissue, and then when people open them, I'll just instruct them to be really careful.
And there's those little cardboard inserts that give the box stability.
Yes.
And just a drop of glue, I think, will
work. Yep. Actually, I put a drop there. I just must have upped it a little bit.
Okay.
But that is what my job today is going to be, is finish these boxes so that I can start packing. But just, Rick's artwork is something else.
Wasn't this the one that was giving you a little eyeball challenge?
Oh my gosh, I'd start cutting and then I'd see, oh, look at this red in here. And then I'd get up here and then see this, and then over here was just way out of sight because there was just so much to look at. But I mean, each one is such a delight.
Well, they are colorful.
They are very colorful. Whoopsie.
Well, the digital quilt I'm working on right now takes over six football fields in length, that spans the length of over 6 football fields.
Yes.
Each original section was 38 by 38 stretch canvas.
I only needed 8 inches.
Yeah. So I had to shrink these. But it was a fun challenge for me to work
definitely.
On.
Definitely. And I know in the past you've made triangular boxes.
Yep.
You've
circular,
made small ones.
Right.
You've made larger ones. But this is the size I want. He did make me some smaller ones that I have not yet cut out. But look at those. Those are going to be absolutely darling. And then the proportions of these look like they're 2 inches by 4 inches.
Yeah, about that.
Mm-hmm.
I try to keep them proportionate. I experimented by stretching, but then I soon found out that the sides wouldn't be the same, you know, proportion, only because the way I was just arbitrarily measuring and shaping them.
Right.
But I got the idea now, so.
Definitely.
So how many more boxes do you want?
Well, I need enough for all of these guys.
Well, you have enough here already. My goodness.
Well, I might just hang them all around the house just the way they are. One thing I hadn't thought about when I was creating them, but realized after I got a few of the pieces of heavier stones on here, that sometimes I needed to have another anchor, something to hold it straight, and something if I... Some of these... This is actually hardwood mulch, so... I don't know what some of these pieces are, but they're really, really difficult to drill or grind little grooves in.
Could be oak.
It could be. And so I ended up putting little rocks behind some of the ones that were not as stable. And then on this one in particular, I had to put a little rock anchor here to keep it from flipping. But that's something, you know, as you're working on it, that's how you have to change what you're doing and make it work. Now, when I cut out these boxes, you could see that there was a lot of white paper around it, and I didn't want to throw that away. This is photo gloss paper, and when you mark on it with markers, the colors just pop. Well, I know two little boys that are always drawing. They're always designing things, so I've been cutting up the pieces and saving them for them so that they can do whatever they want, make ornaments, make signs, whatever. So we try not to waste anything if we possibly can. When you're folding one of these boxes, you have to decide, well, where do I want to start? There are the lines that I need to follow, and that's the thing that I'm going to try to follow the most. So I fold it over until I can see the black line. And then I rub it down.
Could use a cuttle bone or your bone, your whale bone to...
I could, but actually it's... I didn't want to be scratching
up.
Anything.
Yeah.
I figured my hands would be less abusive.
Okay. I mean, some people use a ruler or a plastic triangle to fold things
sure.
to, but...
Yep.
No.
Inches on whatever works for you, that's what you're doing. So once that's bent, then when you put it up, that gives you the box shape, gives the shape. So that will be glued. Now that I have it all folded, I'm using my go-to glue, which is Arlene's Fast Tacky Glue. And when it comes out of the bottle, it's like this. You can just see how thick it is. That's why they call it Fast Tacky, because it's going to stay almost immediately when you put it on. So these are the flaps, and I don't want the glue to come squirting out, but even if it did, it dries invisibly, so really doesn't make any difference.
Crystal clear.
Yep, and it's very strong. Like I said, I was thinking about using a hot glue gun, but I don't have as much control with that as I would with Arlene's, so I decided I'm going this way. Now, the tricky thing is, once you get these all glued and you're trying to get them in position, sometimes they don't like to stay in position.
I suppose you could do one at a time.
You could, but then you have to keep bending the paper open. So if I had three hands, it would be even better.
How about four hands?
No. Okay, so now is you put it in place. Hold it for a few minutes or a few seconds.
So does it hold pretty quickly then?
Yes, it does. That's why they call it fast tacky. Okay, and you get this one done. And this is now where I can bend it down, actually, and actually
press it down.
Press it in place, right. And kind of spread the glue in where I want it. Same thing on the other side. There we go. Now I won't be finished with this. I'll give it a couple of more presses before I actually think it's done. Then inside is my structure piece. And once I'm sure that that's all glued, I will be putting this down inside the box itself, putting a little dab of glue here and sticking it onto the inside of the box on both sides. And that'll hold it in place. That also gives the box structure and kind of a little more protection for my little owl pieces. And then as you're working, you want to go back and make sure that each corner is lined up the way you want it. And just kind of give it a little nudge to keep it where it belongs. I'm not real happy with this side, so I will come back in here and give it a little nudge. So there is some playtime on here. It's not like instant grab, like that super glue. It's not like super glue. This is a little more forgiving than that.
And then how long do you allow the box to dry before you put the insert in?
Not very long. A minute, 2 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Now that we've let the glue sit for a little bit, I need to test my structure. Now remember, when you're making the inside structure, it has to be a slightly smaller so that it fits inside and it doesn't push out your edges. Looks good.
The height okay?
Yep.
Well, if it isn't, this is a good time to cut it.
Right, before you glue it in.
Yep.
Yes. In order to do that, I'm just going to get a little piece of glue. And again, it just needs to be a little bit just to hold it where I want it. The other side. Again, just a little bit of pressure. Within a minute or two, it's done. And there you go. Box number two. I mean, just the box itself is a gift, let alone what might be inside. Thank you, honey.
You're welcome. What else do you need?
Don't even ask. This part, creating these boxes, has been almost as fun as putting the little owls together. Once Rick got started with his digital prints and all the different images and the brightness, we just kind of fell in love with it and started creating a whole bunch of them. You could do the same thing, develop your pattern. There are books that show how to make patterns for boxes. In a craft store, they already have papers that are decorated. And if you have a printer, or computer. You could actually just print them out yourself. Lots of varieties. What we were trying to do now is figure out, well, how do we get these to stay closed without ruining the design? We want to make it so that if you wanted to use the box again, you could. You could use stick-on labels for gifts, but I think those would not peel off again. So we came upon Post-it notes. I'm sure if you go to the office stores or the craft stores, they probably have them in seasonal shapes. That was fine. We didn't have them. We just decided, well, let's experiment. This one, not only does it tell me who it's for, but it also holds it in place just enough. Here I just used a bigger one, put the sticky side on the side so that it would hold it closed. Last but not least, you have to put the little creation into the box and make sure that it's not going to be wiggling around or something's going to bump into it or it'll knock all the stones right off the stick. So after thinking about tissue paper, which I thought was going to be too hard, Excelsior paper is going to stick to some of my plants. Tissue, regular old tissue, and I'm just putting some at the bottom. Give it a base. Lifting up my little creation, setting it in. And then it's just a matter of putting more around it.
Just to protect it, right?
Just to protect it, right. And especially these little flowery shapes. Not that they would come out. I think my glue is going to be holding it nicely, but for me, I think it gives me the peace of mind that I know it's not going to go anywhere. Yeah, it doesn't even shake if I jiggle it back and forth. Now, I'll probably carry all of these in another box so they're holding each other in place rather than just in a bag or carrying them. I think that would be better. Next time you're walking through your garden or even a park or along the sidewalk, kind of look down every now and again because who knows what you'll find that will inspire you to do something with it. I have to thank my friend Ann Berg. She's the one that inspired this. This had to be over 50 years ago that she created this little owl that she had sitting on, I think, another stick or a log or something. Over the years, it's fallen off, but I've kept it because it meant so much to me and it was unique. Well, it's getting late into the evening, but I wanted to finish up at least the little faces, the little owls themselves on the stones. So I have a variety of sizes and shapes and colors, and now the next task is to find out which ones will go on which stick, piece of wood. And that's just a matter of what looks good to me and, you know, what's going to look good to somebody else. Now, these little guys, we have drilled holes into the actual wood and then glued them in, and these still need to be drilled. And so we'll be adding different things to different ones and just having fun. But we thought maybe you'd like to see some of the things I do during the winter. And Rick is busy with his artwork, making cards for me to send out as greeting cards. And we find many things to do, even though it's cold outside. We have been in Santa's workshop here, putting together our boxes, our art boxes, for the little sticks and stones creatures. Just love the way these look. Like I said, the boxes are as much of a gift as the what's going to be inside of them. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. And we'd love to hear what you've been making, creating, things that we probably haven't even thought about. We'd love to hear about it. Thank you so much for watching, and if you'd like to become part of our garden conversation, please hit that little subscribe button here and become part of our garden family.
Actually, it's right down there.
Right down here?
Yes. Way in the corner. Way in the down corner. Here. Right there.
It's in there somewhere. If you'd like to subscribe, we'd love to have you. Thank you.
I don't know
you.
Why they make it so tiny. It used to be nice and large. Now it's a tiny little red thing down in the bottom that says subscribe, you know.
Just keep looking. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.